Innovation implementation strategy, radical innovation of 3D printing of concrete. What's to the end to get a tour around the factory? Radical innovation is one of the four innovation strategies you might choose. You get a clear understanding of how radical innovation starts and how it is transformed from a crazy idea on a post-it to a full operational 3D printing factory 6 years later. Let's start straight away.
Welcome at Bruil Prefab Printing. My name is Theo Voogd. I'm the innovation manager of Bruil. Bruil is a mid-sized company based in the Netherlands on 13 locations. We get in digital concrete printing because in 2013 and 14, the Netherlands were in a deep crisis. And we, as a traditional concrete company, had to innovate.
End of 2014, they used the fourth innovation methodology to ideate and develop six new business cases, among which 3D printing of concrete. Now, fourth is a proven method combining business thinking with design thinking, where an innovation team, including the top management, enrolls on an innovation expedition of 15 weeks. 3D printing of concrete was in 2014 still a technological dream, but a good innovation is a new solution for a relevant customer friction. The customer need for 3D printed concrete was discovered in the island Observe and Learn, where architects complained that there was no work for them anymore because beautiful buildings get too expensive, as you can see here. On the island Raise Ideas, Bruil generated 964 new ideas, and the 15 best ones were chosen and worked out as a concept. 3D printing was called in Dutch 3D Mortelprinter, and it was the favorite idea out of all 15, as you can see here, where we got 7 hearts attached to it. The 3D printing concept scored a 9 on attractiveness, but in 2014 had only a feasibility of 20%. Nevertheless, Bruil chose 3D printing as one of the 6 business cases to be worked out, as clients and architects were thrilled by the idea on the island of test ideas. At the end presentation, on the island homecoming, next to more evolutionary ideas, the concept of 3D printing of architectonical concrete was chosen by the leadership to be implemented. It got both staff and funded. And Bruil decided, very clever, to develop this revolutionary concept as a separate startup in a garage setting. After years of experimenting and failing, experimenting and failing, by the way, FAIL stands for first attempt in learning. And they tested it and they got their first mover clients coming up in small projects, and it became clear that a real business became viable. The garage 3D startup was promoted into a formal business unit, and Bruil invested in a complete new prefab digital printing factory, which was opened fall of 2020. And Theo Voogd, innovation manager, will talk to you about the star project they got now, Gaudi type of printed 3D concrete elements.
Our star project at the moment is project Baskerweg in Den Helder. Here we're going to upgrade 2 apartment buildings of in total more than 150 apartments. The project consists in total 1200 3D printed elements like facade panels, balustrades and columns. The client wants to have bigger balconies on the existing building, so we place in front of the facade a new structure. The 3D printed elements are attached to the new structure. The new structure is carrying all the weight and is only attached to the existing building. In this building, we have more than 160 different shapes and sizes.
Thank you, Theo, for explaining. And now, Elise, can you tell us more about the 3D printing factory, how it really works?
3 years ago, I came to Bruil, and then we had a good prototype 3D printer. It was my role to turn this prototype into a production machine and to create the entire process around the 3D printer. To be able to print multiple objects in a day, we have placed the robot on the track so that we have a greater reach and that the elements have time to settle and to harden before we need to remove them again. What makes this location unique is that we do not just have a 3D printer, but we've created an entire production line where you can also coat the elements, but also saw them so they can be attached to the existing building. One of the strengths of our 3D printer is that we have a high control over our printhead. So we can orient it in different directions to create freeform elements, but also we have very high control over the amount of material which is deposited so that we are able to make very accurate elements. An architect gives us a 3D model. This model probably comes from a spirometric model. This model is then translated into robot code, almost fully automatically. And this robot code contains all the information necessary for production, how the robot should move and how much material needs to be deposited. As soon as the production line has been started and the right robot code has been selected, the process is fully automatic and does not require any human intervention.
Now watch next this movie on the Innovation Matrix, where you get a good insight in all four innovation strategies with other innovation examples of Breuil. Let's innovate and stay safe.